Hello again, this is still Max, and you are probably still, or not still, watching Random Old School Yu-Gi-Oh! And if you saw my first video or my first part of this collection, you will know that I will randomly insert some of the highlights in between the video, so there's not really a point in scrolling to the end and waiting for that time to show all the highlights. But you can bear with me going through this collection. And yeah, I will randomly insert some of the highlights for you, just to show you some of them. I can start with a few. We have, okay, this is not really a highlight, but this is Emissary of the Afterlife from AST, Heavy Storm. We got some decent gold cards for the fusion deck, Ryusenshi, a Dark Necrophyr. This is one of my favorite cards from back in the day because I once ran it and yeah, in my Kuribo themed deck. So Kuribo being Fiend and other Fiend cards like Opticlops and Mask of Darkness and stuff, and Sangen of course. Yeah, we're used to bring this one out. We have a Jinzo from the 2003 tins in very good condition. So this is one of the more valuable cards. We have a Dark Magician. You can see it's a German one. First edition from Starter Deck Yugi. Unfortunately, it's not quite as valuable as the English version. So yeah, I expected it to be yeah, around like maybe 50 euros or something, but it's more like 20. But still a cool card. We have Ojama King in Ultimate Rare, first edition. Unfortunately, the condition is not too great. As you can see, the edges and the corners took quite some damage. And the back is a little bit, yeah, blunt, I guess. Not as clean as if it was freshly out of the pack, but nonetheless, it's an old school Ultimate Rare in first edition. We have Torrential Tribute in first edition from Labyrinth of Nightmare. Another cool card with a simple artwork, and yeah, I don't know. I like the blue holos or blue holo cards pictures, like with Mirror Force that has some blue in it as well. And the same goes for Torrential Tribute. I mean, it's like yeah, a blast from the past. It's been like 13 years since this came out, so yeah, I was 13 back then. We have Skilled Dark Magician from Magician's Force. It's first edition as well. Then we have one of my most frequently played cards of all times, I guess, Lava Golem. I'm pretty much playing this in almost every deck I'm using. Because it's removal even against cards that can't be targeted or destroyed or whatever. And most decks nowadays end with more than one monster on their board. So yeah, Lava Golem is a cool card in my opinion. We have a Sacred Phoenix of Nephthys, another German version, Ultimate Rare First Edition from Rise of Dest Flaming Eternity, not Rise of Destiny. The creator was from Rise of Destiny. Yeah, its condition is okay, I guess, but I would not consider this being close to near mint. But still, it will look nice in my binder. I'm losing my ability to speak English properly, I guess. But at least I'm not drooling over those cards. So yeah, that's that. Going on with someone, or not someone. As I said, I'm losing my language. We go on with some commons, like Jar of Greed, some Book of Lives for the zombie players. These are reprints, most of them, I guess. Yeah, from Evolution starter decks, or Dark Beginning, or Dark Revelation. We have some old structure deck holos in here, and some, yeah, low-level fusion monsters. Usable for gold format to bring out with Metamorphosis if you ever want to, I guess. Ojama King, yeah, the common version. So now we are getting into some, yeah, some elemental heroes. Some of them are even first edition from the Lost Millennium, as you can see. And the nice thing about this is you can build like deck cores for classic elemental hero decks with these cards. So even though they are commons, they are not like useless. We have Skyscraper, two of them actually in first edition, super rare from Cybernetic Revolution, and a Bubble Shuffle in Ultimate Rare, which is not really valuable, but whatever. It can make a deck look a little prettier if you want to use it, that is. Going on. We will see some gold cards now from different reprint sets. So we have a DD Warrior Lady, we have Exarian Universe, which is debated if it belongs into gold format or not, because I don't know the exact reasons. I should probably have checked that. Now I look dumb, but it's four Exarians, all from the collector tins of 2005, I think. Metamorphosis from DR1 and from PGD. Cyberjar, we have an ultra rare Smashing Ground, two actually, one English one, one German. Sakus, Bottomless Trap Holes, we have some more Messengers of Peace and some more draw power, yeehaw. Creature Swap, which can be used with scapegoats to steal opponents' monsters. Apprentice Magicians, a playset, a Reflect Bounder, ultra rare from Dark Crisis. I'm not too sure if this one is in bad condition or not. Oh yeah, this one is one of the damaged ones. Should probably put it over to the lilies and stuff. Tsukuyomi, a very good gold card actually. Some Stealth Birds to burn. King Tiger Wanghu. More Exarians. Ultra Rare Dust Tornadoes. And some lesser rarities. Dark Mimic. Monster Reincarnation to use with Night Assailant. One Spirit Reaper from Gold Series 4, which is soon to be followed by another one from the Premium Gold, I guess, accompanied by Morphing Jar Reasoning. So these are basically old cards in newer versions, newer in quotation marks. Some Monarchs, some Berserk Gorillas, shout out to Chris, a friend of mine who used to play a Zoo Beatdown deck back in the day. He's not playing anymore, but he loved his Berserkers. Another one. Here are the upstarts from Retro Pack 1. Yes. Darkblade the Dragon Knight in Ultimate Rare in beat-up condition, unfortunately. I guess because it's a fusion, I could technically play it in gold format decks, but I'm not too sure if I will do that. I can use a lower rarity version of it as well. Exiled Frost from the Hobby League. Question. Yay. Dark Flare Knight, a Monster Reborn from DB1. Ultra rare, German version, of course. Call of the Haunted. We have a Lightning Vortex, Donzaluk, and Crest for Charity with another Reflect Bounder. This one should be in better condition. Yes. This was one of the nicer ones. I mean, it's not perfect, but okay, I guess. Let's grab some of those cards now. Again. So we are starting off with two Ultimate Rares from Soul of the Duelist, a Mystic Swordsman Level 2, first edition Ultimate Rare, accompanied by his older brother, I guess, the Level 4 version, first edition Ultimate Rare as well. Mirror Wall from PSV, Gravity Bind, Magical Merchant, Catapult Turtle, more Magical Merchants for Gold format. Tyranitar Tribute, Judgment of Anubis, more upstarts. This is relinquished from Starter Deck Pegasus. Some Null and Voids, some other super rares, and yeah, Prohibition. This is good for the Mystic Mine players, which I would count myself towards. Magic Cylinder, a Skill Drain, good rare from Dark Crisis. Ceasefire and two more of the Emissary of the Afterlife. I'm confused myself about my system, which I sorted the cards in, because this was supposed to be the highlight pile. I mean, there are some good cards in here, but not the very very expensive ones. But whatever. Next up, we get some. How do I describe this? Some cards that can be sorted together because they belong to a certain duelist in the original series, or that fit into the same type of character deck or archetype deck. So we have Exodia set from Yugi's Legendary decks. It's the complete thing. Whoops. Yay. Another random leg in common. Dark Magicians. A lot of Dark Magicians in different versions. Among them is an Ultimate Rare version from some kind of structure deck, I guess. It's not too valuable, but it looks nice in Ulti. More Mirror Forces, Breakers, Brain Controls, Yugi cards, essentially. A random Pot of Greed, because everybody plays Pot of Greed. Even a Yugi token, more Dark Magicians. Simply cards Yugi's using in the anime, along with the Egyptian God cards. We have Summoned Skull from Duelist Pack Yugi in Super Rare with the alternate artwork. I don't like this as much as I do like the original one, but yeah, I mean, it looks a little more lightning-y, if you want to say so. That was like the twist in the anime. He attacked with electricity, and the wetted Great Moth was like a big lightning rod for it. And so Yugi won against Weavile, which was pretty weird. But I guess main character powers. Let's put those over here. Let me pick up the Kaiba cards. I guess these are the Kaiba cards. Yes, they should be. We have, of course, Blue Eyes, some cost downs, and other ways to cheat it out with less tributes. Of course, this is not an LOB version. It would be nice if it was, but it isn't. Legendary Collection versions, Evolution deck versions, Kaiba Man himself, and generic support cards for Blue Eyes, Pot of Greed again, why not Vampire Lord? He played this randomly. Shrink is one of his signature spell cards, and the XYZ Dragon Cannon materials alongside their fusions. Enemy Controller, another prominent spell card of Kaiba in different rarities. Late Knight and Voss Raider for level 4 beat sticks, and the infamous Ring of Destruction. So, I think it's the right way to make a third video with the remaining cards. We will have some of the Joey cards over here and the rest of my highlight pile. So, stay tuned for that and see you next time. Goodbye!